This is a really big topic. A lot of you guys, you wonder which software you should choose to do your recording. Should you choose Studio One or should you choose Pro Tools? If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you can make sure that you get alerts every time I drop a new video.
HVH on the beat, boy. Yeah, I just made this YouTube and it's popping. Dropping content weekly, I ain't stopping. Sean Zill, say my name, run it up, 100K.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Zonzel. A lot of you guys, you wonder which software you should choose to do your recording. Should you choose Studio One or should you choose Pro Tools? There's a few other ones out there, but those are the main two fighting for the top spot. Pro Tools, I grew up off Pro Tools. I've been using Pro Tools ever since I was 14 years old. Like, Pro Tools is tight. It has a dope sound quality. Pro Tools stock plugins are probably the best stock plugins I ever used. Like, just their EQ band is dope. Their compressor, it's tight and it's exclusive. Like, you're not going to be able to take that out and put it into a Fruity Loops or into a Studio One. Like, that stays in Pro Tools. You can actually install it without paying for it. I mean, that's illegal. Like, y'all shouldn't be doing that. But people can do that with Pro Tools. And you're not going to be able to do that with Studio One. You got to know somebody who has a login for that. But Pro Tools is expensive. That's a big thing about Pro Tools. It costs so much money to get the software. It is a great software though. Only thing about Pro Tools that I really don't like is just how hard it is to install third-party VSTs. I don't like how there's not really a drag and drop function in it. It's pretty advanced. And that's good for those who are already advanced. As many of you guys know, that's the industry standard. So pretty much any studio you go to, you're probably going to see Pro Tools. But Pro Tools also has this yearly subscription thing now where you got to upgrade. It didn't used to be like that. Moving on to Studio One. Studio One is killing it. I used to look at Studio One like the little brother to Pro Tools. But now, it's like, okay, that little brother is just better than the big brother now. Well, that's like Studio One out of all these. There's Cubase, there's Logic, there's FL, there's, you know, Pro Tools, but yet and still, Studio One, which was the last one to be made, crushed all of them. The drag and drop function, everything is drag and drop. You want to EQ, you want to effect, anything like that, drag and drop. You want an instrument, drag and drop. Another thing, you want to throw in third-party VSTs, easy. You just install, locate them. Pro Tools, it ain't that simple. Sometimes it don't read them in Pro Tools. But in Studio One, it reads it every time. Studio One is a lot quicker for you to just flow. It's a lot easier for you to make your beats on it too. They have a thing like Fruity Loops has, you know, that little drum pattern thing. Studio One has that. Pro Tools don't. Studio One has the piano roll, just like Pro Tools. But there's just more to it. If you guys been watching my video, Studio One's for anybody, all the way from a beginner to an advanced, like an expert who really knows their stuff. I recommend getting Studio One. It's a whole lot cheaper and you only pay one time for it. You get all those for free, the upgrades, 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. Right now we're on like 4.5, 4.6. Then once it's 4.9, you gotta pay for 5. But you can keep, some people still are on Studio One 3 Professional, killing it. And that's another thing. There's like three different softwares for it. There's like Studio One Prime, Studio One Artist, and Studio One Professional. Pro Tools is just Pro Tools. So there you have it. Those are the differences. If you have Pro Tools, it's cool. Like, use Pro Tools. It's tight. If you have Studio One, use it. I know Pro Tools is starting to integrate. They're starting to allow you to use your hardware for it. So, hey, give it a try. But I just want to thank you guys for watching this video. Please, again, subscribe, like this video, comment. Tell me what you think is better, Pro Tools, Studio One, or whatever you're using. All right, we out of here.
Dropping content weekly, I ain't stopping. Sean Zill, say my name, run it up, 100K.